Understandably, companies with thousands or hundreds of thousands of employees don't want to pay license fees like this if some of their employees don't even have computers on which to receive emails. They don't have email addresses, and often, they don't have business smartphones either. I have a lot more to say about this topic, so we should talk more about mobile apps later. Super fast and stable, with reliable push notifications. As I see it, push notifications represent another fundamental and important piece of the group chat puzzle. These notifications are displayed actively, often accompanied by a sound, on your smartphone screen, even when it's locked, to grab your attention. We'll talk about their disadvantages later. The advantage of push notifications is that they facilitate instant availability and reconciliation. Push notifications are so effective that while I'm writing these lines on the train on the way back from Berlin, they're allowing me to chat with my colleague Inga, who's sitting at the opposite table in the same compartment less than 2 meters away. It means we can chat with each other without disturbing anyone. We could probably chat with each other directly, but things are so tranquil in the compartment, and the chat also involves our colleague Sebastian, who is in a completely different location. To outsiders, scenarios like this may seem absurd, and stand-up comedians have been known to spoof them live on stage. But they're also effective for communicating across different and distant locations. For this to work, however, the notifications in a chat solution have to function properly. Server located on the open internet. Legitimate discussions take place in lots of organizations about whether their own, and often secret, data should be stored in the public cloud on foreign servers owned by American companies. However, the solutions from Microsoft, Google, or Salesforce leave you with no other choice. These solutions offer only cloud subscriptions these days. Operating your systems in a proprietary IT infrastructure either never was or no longer is possible. Only smaller providers or open-source solutions offer installations in a proprietary environment behind your own firewall.